Many people want to get started in real estate investing, but are not sure which strategy to use. Others are not sure if it's possible at a younger age or with a lower income. But do not worry, the purpose of this video is to help give you insights into our real estate strategy. Real estate investments can be a powerful tool to help you achieve financial freedom. It doesn't have to be hard or overcomplicated. My wife and I love real estate investing, and we started our investing journey as young college students in Utah. Thank you for tuning in to the Biesinger Fire Journey channel. It would be amazing if you could love this video today. Since there's not a love icon, a like would be perfect. Please comment below with your thoughts and subscribe for more on our financial freedom journey. So when we purchased our first real estate property, we were just college students, ages 21 and 23. We did not have a lot of money and we did not have high paying jobs. But through hard work and dedication, we saved up $20,000 to kickstart our real estate journey. Now that $20,000 has become $400,000 after 5 years. Since we did not have a lot of income as college students, we couldn't follow the BRRRR, the BRRRR strategy, strictly. More on that to come. I want to first share with you our real estate numbers and timeline. So my wife and I's first real estate property was a very nice townhome located in Utah. It had been built in 1970, so a little bit older, and had 2 bedrooms plus 1.5 bath. The total price was $100,000 in 2017. My sweetheart was just 21 years old and I was 23. In total, we saved up $20,000 for our down payment. Since the down payment was 20% of the house price, we did not have to pay mortgage insurance. Yes! Our monthly mortgage payment was around $850 with HOA, taxes, etc. We lived there for over a year and then we rented it out for almost 2 years. The rental income we received a month was $1,000. This gave us $250 extra cash flow each month. In 2020, we ended up selling the property for $140,000. Now onto our second property. We bought this second property, which was a condo, in 2018 when my wife was 22 and I was 24. Upon buying the second property, we rented out the first one. It was after accepting a job offer as an account manager that we decided to upgrade our home and rent out the first property, as I mentioned, becoming first-time landlords. The condo we found had 3 bedrooms and 2 baths and was built in 2002. Being our second property, we could only apply for a conventional loan with a minimum requirement of 5% down payment. We did have to pay the PMI, the mortgage insurance, on this one, since the down payment did not reach 20% of the loan's total amount. The total price of this condo was $171,000. Our down payment plus closing costs were $10,000 total. So our monthly payment with HOA and mortgage insurance included was just about $1,200 a month. When COVID-19 happened, the interest rates dropped significantly, and we noticed these great rates. Because of these great rates, we decided to refinance the condo. After refinancing, our monthly payment went down to around $1,000 with the mortgage, HOA, etc. This saved us $200 a month. After living in the condo for about 2 years, we rented it out. We are still renting out this condo today, and the rental price is $1,330 now. This gives us around $330 a month in cash flow. Just recently, we were checking the same condos in our community and saw the listing price is around $300,000. When we bought it, it was only $170,000. Now onto our third real estate property. This was a new home under construction in July of 2020. The building process was exciting and took 10 months to finish. We officially closed on this third property in May 2021 when my wife was 24 years old and I was 26. The total price of our new single family home was around $340,000. The home is 2,300 square footage with a lot size of 0.12 acres. We saved up a 5% down payment, which cost us $20,000. We had an excellent interest rate locked in at 3%. In total, our mortgage payment each month is $1,530. After we moved in, we finished both our yard and the basement. Lots of tasks and lots of projects, learning new handyman skills. The cost of finishing both our yard and basement was approximately $20,000. A lot of it we did ourselves, but some parts we did hire out as well. Recently, we checked and the same model of home in our community sold for $500,000, $500,000. And that was without the yard and basement being finished. But when we bought ours, it was only $340,000. Since we hit coast fire and moved abroad, this third property is now rented out, providing us with positive cash flows. We rent it out for $2,200 a month. Now let's talk about the BRRRR strategy, and then I will share with you my wife and I's real estate investing strategy. That way you can compare both of their similarities and differences so you can decide which one is best for you. I love this quote from Stephen King that says, "If you can, you should, and if you're brave enough to start, you will." So what is the BRRRR method? This is a strategy for real estate investing that stands for buy, rehab, rent, refinance, and repeat. This methodology can be used in both residential and commercial real estate investing. Okay, so now that you've soaked in the Burr method, I want to share with you our real estate investment strategy. Here's a quick overview. We have found success by first buying as owner-occupied a residential property. Then do some easy remodeling while living there. Next, save up a down payment for the next property. Then buy the next house and rent out the previous one. Repeat the process. This strategy can work for most anybody. We were able to start as young college students. As long as you have that perseverance, you can do it too. And I want to share with you a little bit more on each step. So number one, buy as owner occupied or residential property. Once you have saved up that precious down payment, you will purchase your home as an owner occupied or residential property. It's important to note that when you buy as owner occupied, you can obtain a better interest rate, saving you a lot of money in the long run. Now here is a crucial step. When looking for a house, we would always research extensively how much we could rent out a property for and whether or not it can provide positive cash flows after mortgage payments and other expenses. When we bought our residential property, our lender required us to live there for at least 1 year before converting it into a rental property. Different lenders might have different rules, so it's good to check with your lender first. During the time we lived in the property, we had time to do some remodeling and start saving a down payment for the next home. I cannot emphasize this next part enough. Remember to only buy the house that you can afford, not your dream home. Then, when you have a better financial situation, you can always upgrade to a better house next time. My wife and I always told ourselves that the current property we were in was not our forever home, and it doesn't need to be perfect. It will be our rental one day, providing passive cash flow, and we will work hard for our next property. Having this mindset has been an excellent motivation for us and reminds us to live within our means and not become house poor. Number two is doing some easier remodeling while living there. As mentioned before, our lender required us to live there for at least 1 year before we could convert it into a rental property. We were just college students back then and didn't have a lot of money. There was no way we could afford to buy a rental property directly like some people, or spend a lot of money to hire professional contractors for remodeling. Our first and second properties were secondhand houses, you could say, but our third property was a brand new house we built. The nice thing about the third home is that there was no remodeling needed. So we just did some home improvements such as finishing the yard and basement. When living in our first and second properties, we do some simple remodeling like painting the doors, kitchen cabinets, and swapped out some old appliances. To make your place look nicer before renting, cleaning and painting are the easiest and cheapest ways to remodel your house and make it look 100 times better. Another note is that the seller must have owned the home and used it as their principal residence for 2 of the last 5 years up to the closing date. This means if you've lived in the house for 2 years, you can sell it with zero capital gains tax within the following 3 years. If you plan to sell, it's a good idea to stay there for at least 2 years. Number three is saving up a down payment for the next property. If you know your goal is to purchase another home, you should start saving up your next down payment as soon as possible. Once you have a better paying job or are ready to upgrade your home, you will have the money ready. It would also help you a lot if you had an idea of how much your next house would cost you so that you know how much of a down payment to save. So this part is a little bit different than the traditional Burr strategy because we typically don't refinance our properties and pull out money to buy the next property. We 100% save up the down payment by ourselves because we just feel it's a better option for us with less risk and having a family. Number four, buy the next house and rent out the previous one. This step is so exciting. Once you're ready to buy a new place, it's time to rent out the one you're living in. Usually you need to rent it out and provide the rental agreement and security deposit to your lender to close on your new home. Also make sure to check with your HOA and city to see if there are any other landlord licenses or documents required. So our first property's HOA required a copy of our city's landlord license certificate, but our second and third property HOAs did not. And step number five, repeat the same process. This step doesn't need a whole lot of explanation. Just restart the steps and you'll find a very easy and enjoyable process. Keep the process going and know you can reach your goals in time. Eventually, you'll get into that dream home. Here are some tips for this step. Repeat. Keep track of your finances. Diversify your portfolio, stay disciplined, and learn from past mistakes. Using our real estate strategy can be a great way to succeed in investing and help lower risks associated with typical investing. If you are patient and careful, you can use the strategy to build a portfolio of assets that will provide passive income. Remember this quote from John Stuart Mill, "Landlords grow rich in their sleep." Another way that we love investing in real estate on the side without a lot of money is using Fundrise. It's a crowdsourcing real estate investing platform. With investment minimums of only $10, you can start making passive income with your real estate investment portfolio. Check them out in the link provided in the description below. So real estate investing can be a great way to make money and build wealth over time. But every investment does have risks. It's essential to do your research and understand everything before getting started. One more thing I want to mention is that we have been very fortunate. The past few years have been a perfect and ideal time to invest in real estate in Utah. We could buy a house when the price was still relatively low and then watch it increase in value. Remember that the value of real estate is still increasing over time, and having that rental income as passive income is a fantastic thing. We are so grateful that we have been able to make $400K in profits with our real estate investment strategy. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this video. Feel free to drop a comment or question below. And if you haven't already, please give us a like and subscribe for more on our journey with investing tips.